All right, so Pippa says, please, could you explain the biochemistry behind why medium chain triglycerides generate ketones even when consumed with large amounts of carbs? I understand that they go directly to the liver and are beta oxidized without the need for carnitine palmitoyl transferase. Well, you, I mean, that is the answer. That's the explanation. What I don't understand is why the resulting acetyl-CoA is not just metabolized through the Krebs cycle, given that in the presence of ample carbs, there should be no shortage of oxaloacetate. It's all about the ratio. If you have, I mean, so first of all, this has been shown in human studies. We know for a fact that MCT oil is ketogenic even in the presence of pasta, period, end of story. So I guess the question here is, you know, biochemically, why is it happening? Well, they go into the mitochondria even in the presence of insulin. And a buildup of acetyl-CoA over the incoming oxaloacetate, a high acetyl-CoA to oxaloacetate ratio generates ketones. So the question is, basically this question is, why isn't there enough oxaloacetate? So generally, insulin is going to favor the burning of carbs. And so generally when you have a large input of carbs, you have production of oxaloacetate, but the metabolic conditions are favoring you burning it for energy, not you producing oxaloacetate. And I think it's just a matter of, the ratio and the speed at which things come in. If the MCTs are coming to the mitochondria fast enough and they're exceeding the rate at which oxaloacetate is produced, which is a likely scenario given that production of oxaloacetate from pyruvate is quantitatively minor anyway, and then B, in the presence of carb-stimulating insulin, you are going to get the pyruvate even more preferentially burned for energy. Then you will have plenty of acetyl-CoA molecules that just came in too fast to have an oxaloacetate matching them, and they wind up being ketogenic. So it's not like putting MCT oil on your pasta leads to 3, 4, 5 millimolar plasma ketones. It's just that it leads to some ketones. So let me see if I can, I'm not gonna put too much time into this because if I can't find this quickly, I don't wanna keep people waiting, but let me see if I can find one of these studies really quickly. Okay, I think I actually found it. So in one of these studies where they put a breakfast containing medium chain triglycerides versus long chain triglycerides, and the breakfast was 40% fat by calories. Am I looking at the right study? Oh, no, not that one. Okay, this one. So um, 12 healthy male students, and this is Van Wimmelbeek. Actually, let me make sure I put a link to this study in the show notes. So let me just make a note here. Okay. So 12 healthy male students of normal body weight ate 4 breakfasts, each separated by 1 week in random order. Each breakfast consisted of 300 grams of pasta, 100 grams of tomato sauce, and one of the following: either a low-calorie fat substitute, 40 grams of olive oil, 42 grams of lard, or 42 grams of MCT oil. When the subjects ate any of these breakfasts, their fasting morning ketones before the breakfast were less than 0.1 millimoles per liter beta-hydroxybutyrate. And when they ate the pasta meal with anything besides the MCT oil, this dropped almost to zero. So it was already at, 0.05, and then it flattened off for a couple of hours. But when they had the pasta with the MCT oil, it instead spiked to a little over 0.3 millimolar. So again, like on in a long-term fast, your ketones are going to get, or on a classical ketogenic diet, your beta-hydroxybutyrate is going to get 3 to 4 millimoles per liter. This is 0.3, right? So it's 10 times less ketogenic than the classical ketogenic diet that people are put on for epilepsy. And then in total fasting, your total ketones are getting even higher than that. So it's, MCT oil is not that ketogenic. It's a little ketogenic. And yeah, the carbohydrate can supply oxaloacetate, but if the MCTs are broken down to acetyl-CoA at a faster rate than that oxaloacetate is supplied, you will get ketogenesis out of it. And I think that the rate at which you can supply, it's probably the case that the maximal rate at which you can replete that oxaloacetate is fairly limited. But in the presence of insulin, you are getting more impetus to actually burn the carbs for energy anyway. Tracy Stevenson adds, seems like also if there's enough excess really of carbs in the fed state, then there might be some negative feedback from upfront TCA cycle metabolites for more incoming acetyl-CoA into the TCA, letting acetyl-CoA move toward beta-oxidation. Acetyl-CoA is a product of beta-oxidation, not a input into beta-oxidation. The acetyl-CoA is going into ketogenesis. If there's enough excess of carbs, there might be some negative feedback for more incoming. Tracy, I see what you're saying, but I don't think that's the case. So, as Pippa had brought up originally, the issue is that, generally, if there's a buildup in citric acid cycle metabolites because you have a lot of carbs in the fed state, what that is doing is increasing cytosolic citrate and also increasing mitochondrial citrate. The mitochondrial citrate is going to be one of the factors along with insulin that's going to shut down the carnitine palmitoyl transferase, CPT, which is the entryway for long-chain fatty acids in the mitochondrion. One of the reasons that MCT oil is ketogenic in the absence or in the presence of carbs and insulin is because the MCTs get into the mitochondrion without the need for the carnitine shuttle. So the buildup of citric acid metabolites due to carbs, yes, will shut down the input of long-chain fatty acids in the mitochondria, but not the input of short and medium-chain fatty acids. And Pippa's saying, yes, but won't it supply the oxaloacetate to allow the acetyl-CoA generated in beta-oxidation from those MCTs to enter the citric acid cycle? And yes, in principle, oxaloacetate does that. But I believe the answer is just you can't make enough oxaloacetate under those conditions fast enough, maybe partly due to limiting capacity of oxaloacetate in general, oxaloacetate production from pyruvate in general, and probably also due to the influence of insulin shoving pyruvate towards being being oxidized into acetyl-CoA, probably from both of those things, you just can't you can't make enough oxaloacetate fast enough to deal with that acetyl-CoA load. And remember, it, you know, it's not like there should be a situation other than this where you would expect to need to make that much oxaloacetate. Because generally when you don't have the carbs, you're not trying to make oxaloacetate. You're sending oxaloacetate to gluconeogenesis and you're sending acetyl-CoA to ketogenesis. So generally operating in one of those two states, either you have enough carbs and you replete the oxaloacetate, but your main thing you're doing with carbs is burning them for energy. Or you don't have enough carbs and you're not even trying to replete oxaloacetate, you're using it to make gluconeogenesis. There really isn't a situation physiologically where you would want to take a carb load and mostly make oxaloacetate from it. And I guess the exception is when you're dealing with medium chain triglycerides, but obviously we haven't evolved a need to specifically deal with that one exceptional situation where you have an influx of medium chain triglycerides with carbs. You know, Pacific Island diets have that when they have high starch, high coconut, but apparently the Pacific Island diet doesn't cause a big enough problem to cause human mitochondria to evolve the ability to suppress ketogenesis in response to eating starch with coconut. And so if eating starch with coconut just isn't that harmful, then there's no pressure to evolve an exception to the rule of biochemistry that generally when you have a lot of carbs, you want to burn them for energy. And when you don't have a lot of carbs, you're using oxaloacetate up to make glucose. And there's never a situation where you have a lot of carbs and you're trying to mostly make oxaloacetate with them. So I hope that, I think that answers it. Actually, I'm very sure that answers the question, but hopefully it was clear enough. I know that was very complicated.